So you think it...
Mga kasama namin yan sa Senado.
But you think really, I mean, well, Lenny now is at 17%. I mean, she started with one. She says advertising helped her. She spent 91 million already on TV ads. Mm-hmm. You believe that at this point, there's still a possibility for her to spike up?
Oh, yes. There's a probability.
Okay.
We have over 3 months to go. The official campaign period hasn't even begun. That will start on February 8th, I think. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Okay, and one of the major campaign issues, a few months ago it was income tax reform, and now it's the SSS, monthly pension hike. With President Aquino vetoing the measure from Congress, what will the effect be first on his candidates? Well, specifically on Secretary Mar with a veto.
There'll be some effect. There'll be a slight backlash. That's my prediction. Yeah. It's not going to be a major backlash because they should be able to explain, and if they are able to explain, people might be able to understand. Number one, it would be totally irresponsible to spend $46 billion without telling me where the money is going to come from. You're not going to do that in your household. Mm-hmm. I mean, if you take home 10,000 pesos a month, you're not going to have a budget, a household budget for 15,000. It's just a matter of time before I'll see you in the poorhouse kasi mauubos yung mga savings, mauubos na yun, mauubos talaga. Mm-hmm. And that's what SSS is facing with an outlay of 2,000 pesos per month times 13 months times 1.8 million pensioners, yes. So you're looking at about 46, 48 billion pesos. Aray ko po, you know. That is what I warned the sponsor on the floor.
I was going to ask you, because did you sign? You voted for this.
I signed. Okay. I voted, but I said I'm leaving it up to Malacanang to raise the contributions. The contributions had just been raised to 11% about in 2010 or 2011. So I'm expecting them to raise the contributions commensurate with the numbers that we will have to deal with, which is $46 billion. Instead binito ni President Noynoy.
So what you were expecting is he would approve it with a condition of raising it.
I expected them to raise it. It would have been also dumb on his part to sign it into law.
Okay.
So he properly said, well, I can't raise it, so I'm not signing this into law.
Okay.
Tama po siya. So now, at the risk of being unpopular and losing a few votes, I said, no, I have to. He's right.
Yeah. He's right.
Yeah.
Is it hard for you to say the president is right?
No. Okay. If he's right, I'm very happy to say he's right. But if he's wrong, it's harder for me to say he's wrong.
All right, go on. Okay, so I'm curious. I think the principal author is Senator Cynthia Villar. What were the discussions?
She was a sponsor.
As a principal sponsor.
We actually picked up a bill that had been approved by the House. So no one had really filed it. Although Senator Rector says he did file a bill at the beginning of his term.
Yeah.
Well, okay, be that as it may, it's a popular thing. I mean, if I'll give everybody 2,000 pesos a month, I'm going to be the most popular guy in town. So it's hard to fight the bill. But I knew that any responsible official would not sign this into law unless you had the accompanying income to be able to justify the expenditure.
Because I'll be honest with you, it makes the Senate look bad. I mean, really. I mean, Congress, you can expect, I mean, there are a lot. You know, it's a popular measure. And to be fair, Congressman Nery Colmenares stands by his own numbers or his own calculations. But the Senate of 24... So actually then, you know, not... Well, you have Senator Enrile who did not vote.
Yes, but I'm not going to make excuses. Tinambakan ho kami ng mga bills. All right? Me alone, I had to sponsor about 54 bills into law these past 4 weeks. And it's been very taxing because iba-iba yung subject na.
Yeah.
And I still have another, well, I've passed 40 as of day for yesterday, so I still have another 14 to pass into law in the next 2 weeks. Yeah.
So, Senator, is it
so
possible?
We were not paying attention to everybody's bills.
Okay. So now I want.
Okay, na ba yan? Okay, sige na.
So let's be honest. Now this is a first time admission. Is it possible that really the senators just really didn't take the time to go through this, do the math, really think about the effect.
Yes, especially on my part. I'm sorry, but it didn't fall in my committee, so pinabayaan ko na sa committee ni Senator Villar. Although I think I was a secondary referral because I'm the chairman of committee on banks, financial institutions, and currencies.
Yeah.
So I was a secondary referral. But normally we just let the primary committee take care of things because we just don't have the time to pay enough attention to the bill.
Yeah.
So yes, I'm at fault also. But
okay.
Still, I'm telling you, we didn't have time.
Yeah. Is this how the 1 billion pesos for the 2016 budget of family planning commodities get scrapped, and you have Senator Pia Cayetano coming to the show saying, I didn't see it. None of us knew.
Yes.
This is how it happens.
The budgets, they stick. Unless you are watching your pet department, it's almost impossible.
If not, things will... I mean, that's the interesting part. So you believe that in the end, I mean, the Senate was not able to scrutinize it the way the public is doing now.
That's right.
Now, all of us are scrutinizing it now.
And I'm glad. I'm really glad the public is scrutinizing it because we would have lost a lot of goodwill that we've gained with the international rating agencies if we come up with a dumb move like this. I'm telling you, next week, if the president had signed this into law without any income, without knowing where the income would come from, by next week, Moody's, Standard & Poor's would have dropped our rating.
They would how would that affect us?
It will affect us because the interest rates on our borrowings abroad are going to go up. So like almost every year we would issue about $2 billion in treasury bonds, 25-year bonds. So instead of paying 3%, we might have to pay 5% or 6%. The reason why we work so hard to put our financial house in order is to be able to get a better rating, that we become investment grade, which we have become, and that the interest rates that would be charged to us for borrowing money would be low because the risk of our defaulting is very low.
Okay.
But if we do a stupid thing like this, the risk of our default is going to be very high in the eyes of the rate.
My question now is, what do you plan to do? What does the Senate plan to do? You have protesters out in the street. They don't want to take zero. And now SSS...
I agree with them.
Yeah, coming to the show saying 1,000 is hard for us, even 500. Now everyone's put in a bind.
All right. I agree with them, but we can still save this bill. As a matter of fact, I agree with the proposal of Speaker Belmonte. Ang sabi po niya, just pass another bill increasing so that it will be in balance.
And increasing contributions?
Yes.
Okay.
Maybe we'll increase contributions at least by 2%, so 11 to 13%.
Would that be popular in an election year to do?
Hindi naman ganun kalaki eh. Let's say your average salary would be 10,000 pesos and you're paying 11%, so you're paying 1,100 pesos a month.
But not fully yours, kasi nakasplit pa kayo doon ng employer.
That's correct.
Uh-oh.
So it's like 70% to you, 30% to your employer, no? So I'm sure the Filipino people, the member of the SSS, know that it would be irresponsible for us to do what the public really wants us to do, because in 12 years that SSS will be bankrupt.
Okay. Now, what about House Bill 6112? SSS President and CEO Emilio De Quiros was here yesterday, and one of their concerns he said that could help is the passage of 6112, wherein it gives more power to the SSS to make these decisions on the long-term viability of the company.
Ayan pong sinasabi ni Speaker Belmonte.
And raising contributions.
Yes. Pass 6112 and send it to the Senate. We can pass it in 1 week.
Oh, you can. And give the SSS the whole managerial decision on what to do with the finances.
Yes. So it will always be in balance. We have to be very responsible about these things.
Okay. Yeah. Okay. Are you a GSIS member?
No. Yes.
You aren't?
Because I'm in government. I used to be with the SSS long ago.
Okay. Yeah. No, but even... But senators are not with GSIS members, right? I mean, if you're an elected official, you are?
They already paid me. They consider me retired already.
So how much did you get? A month?
No, not a month. It was a lump sum. Yeah.
Because that's the difference that SSS is saying. Yeah. In GSIS, there are bigger contributions. So the retirement is bigger. The pensions are bigger.
Yes. And I've always thought of merging GSIS and SSS.
Really? Can you do that? But legally?
Yeah. I mean, in the United States, they only have one. The social security system.
But then the SSS is considered a private fund. What would the...
We'll make the GSIS also a private fund because essentially that is a fund that is contributed to by the members. And it's salary based, no? So it's what they call, in America they call this a payroll tax. But in America, they don't have this big pondo because it's the U.S. government that makes sure that it's liquid and they'll be able to meet their obligations. And they're so big and they're so rich that that's not a problem.
Yeah.
Here, it has
Except
become
during
a standalone.
The crisis. No, during the crisis.
Yes, that's
the
correct.
People's 401k collapsed.
Yes.
Okay, no, but I want to ask you, how would you make that legal? The GSIS members would not agree because they put more money. How would you do that? That's a very interesting perspective.
You can work it out. The actuarians or the actuaries can work it out.
Okay, so if you win, or when you win as senator this 2016, would that be a priority for you?
I think so. I think I'll make it a priority now, having seeing this problem. Alam mo bakit napakayaman ng GSIS?
Oo.
Number one, they're only collecting from government employees.
Yeah.
And so they have control over all the government payrolls, whether you're in the municipality of so-and-so or you're in the province of so-and-so or in working for the DOTC or the NAPO Corps. Kayang-kaya ng gobyerno yan. That is mine, you know. In SSS, you've got 2 million, 3 million private companies. And it's very hard to run after all these people because one day they're there, the next day they're gone. Then 3 months later, they turn up in another address, no? So, ang hirap kumolekta dyan. And the collection rate is lower, like 11% is the rate. In GSIS, it's 19%.
Yeah, yeah.
And then collecting from the employer is so easy because the government is the employer.
Yeah.